Greetings and welcome to this week's Primed Insight. My name is Gavin Gooden and I'm the Marketing Director here at BlastOne. Today we're answering a commonly asked question that is asked in the industry. How much deliquescent does my air dryer use and how often should we refill it? Deliquescent dryers are used by blasters in very humid climates and also in climates where the temperature drops below freezing, where a normal after-cooler style air prep would have problems with the water freezing up. So how much deliquescent will an air dryer use? We have created a table with some very rough numbers of what you can expect to use per day depending on the airflow and ambient air temperatures. There are many variables that can change these results, so this is just a simple rough guide. Here's an example. If you're running a 1600 CFM air dryer, you'll use 1 pound of deliquescent per hour, and that's on a 65 degree day. On an 85 degree day, that will double to 2 pounds of deliquescent per hour. And on a 105 degree day, you'll use 4 pounds per hour. To show the benefit of this air dryer for just one single warm day, a 1600 CFM air dryer can remove up to 120 gallons of water. So what is deliquescent desiccant? Deliquescent desiccant is a drying agent that dissolves and is used to remove moisture from air to ensure that it doesn't enter into your blast pot and clog up your abrasive. Using an air dryer with a blasting system will save you about 15% of your abrasive, guaranteed. Dry light deliquescent desiccant will lower the dew point in your blasting air by 20 degrees, which will be about 10 degrees above the ambient temperature. This will be enough to ensure that you don't get moisture into your blast pot and into your blasting system. This dew point can be easily checked using a Deliquescent dew point meter. So how does deliquescent desiccant work inside an air dryer? So say today is an 85 degree day and it's quite warm and humid. So the air coming out of your compressor will be about 250 degrees because it heats up a lot. It'll come down your bore hose into the inlet tank and then through the after cooler. So if your after cooler is sized correctly for the amount of airflow, it'll effectively cool that incoming air by 10 degrees warmer, 210 degrees warmer than ambient. So say it's an 85 degree day, coming out of the after cooler, the air will be 95 degrees. So 95 degree air will come into the bottom of our coalescing tank. The air then will rise slowly through the bed of deliquescent, which is inside this tank, and that will absorb all the moisture, liquid, and humidity out of the air. It then exits out into our final tank. This hill has a demister pad in it, which will capture any final remaining liquid drops that might have made it through the deliquescent. And then it can exit out into your bore hose, to your blast pot. So finally, to achieve all this, you need to ensure that you keep your air dryer in good working order. And here's 4 points how. Use a correctly sized air dryer. Ensure the air motor and the fan is operating correctly and is getting oiled regularly. The air dryer is topped up with deliquescent regularly and the tank is drained of water very regularly, at least daily. Thanks for watching this week's Primed Insight. Please subscribe and we'll see you next week.